Good afternoon. I want to read you a couple of quotes. This is a quote off the council's website this morning. The council's new administration is opposing plans to demolish Charing Cross Hospital and replace it with what is currently planned to be a GP-led clinic. It's also campaigning against the loss of both the borough's local A&Es and has already begun negotiations with government health chiefs. Every time I now go to the council's website, it cheers me up. Just as every time I bump into the local councillors, it cheers me up. And what a difference. What a difference a day makes, that day being May the 22nd. Because now there is a council that will stand behind the campaigners here, will stand behind the NHS, and will do everything in its power to ensure that we save our hospitals and save our A&Es. And after 2 years of betrayal and 2 years of disinformation and lies coming out of the town hall, that's a powerful friend and ally to have on our side. So I want to say, I can't say it enough to say to everybody who worked for the Labour victory in Hammersmith on May the 22nd, you didn't just do it for the Labour Party, you didn't just do it for yourselves, you did it for everybody in this borough, and particularly everybody who relies on hospital services, so well done. But in fact, although the election was on May the 22nd, the council didn't take over until the AGM on the 16th of June. So actually, it was only on the 16th of June that the new administration took control. So I was slightly surprised on the morning of the 17th of June that somebody tweeted this at me. And I understand why I'm reading this, given where we are. Frank Bamfield Park has become a disgrace under a Labour council. Drunks on benches and litter everywhere. No longer safe. Well, I'd like to pay tribute to those Labour councillors. It only took 12 hours to turn this paradise into a litter-strewn, drunk-infested, unsafe hellhole. Well done. And I'd like to thank the drunks of Hammersmith and Fulham for being so responsive to the political climate that they suddenly realised on May the 22nd that, off to Frank Bamfield Park. That tweet did come from the sister of the Tory candidate for Hammersmith, to be fair. But I think it's quite illustrative of what we are now dealing with. Yes, they don't control the town hall anymore, but the disinformation and the lies, I'm afraid, still continue. And we saw that this week in relation to Sullivan School and what they're now saying about the Fulham Boys School, if you've been following that story, how apparently Michael Gove's withdrawn the money for that and it's all our fault. We've seen it with the fact they're still trying to demolish West Kent Estate, but I can tell you I was at a meeting of 150 tenants on West Kent Estate this week who voted unanimously to get control and ownership of their own estate and to stop Capco demolishing it. If you read the property pages of the Evening Standard, you would have seen a two-page feature on White City, in which it described White City, as it will now be, as a banker and broker enclave. And Old Oak, as we know, is going to be, according to Boris, the mini Manhattan. So they haven't got away, unfortunately. They're still here, all those terrible people who try to wreck not just lives, but buildings, communities, the whole of the borough. They're still there working away with their allies in City Hall and their allies in government. So the struggle goes on. And no issue is that struggle more important than on saving the NHS and saving our hospitals. And I just want to thank Save Our Hospitals, as I always do on these occasions, because every single member of Save Our Hospitals, and many of the most active people are here today, spend a huge part of their lives campaigning, not on their own behalf, on behalf of the NHS, on behalf of everybody who uses hospitals in this borough and in London, and I cannot thank them enough. They have done a fantastic effort. They're buoyed, I know, we're all buoyed by the fact that we're winning new allies and new friends, including the council, but we must go on. We must ensure that we have a government. We must ensure we have a trust in Imperial who are on the patient side and on the NHS side, not on the side of big business and our own self-interest. And I say that advisedly because this is another quote. This is a quote from the board papers of Imperial last month. Work is underway to identify sufficient capacity, but this is unlikely to conclude prior to the closure of the emergency unit. They're talking about Hammersmith Hospital. They're talking about the decision they voted through without any discussion to close the A&E at Hammersmith, the one that Chris McGurk said has 22,000 patients every year, to close it when on their own admission there is not capacity in the system. The current capacity at St Mary's for acute admissions is already at maximum capacity. That's what they said, that's what they read, and then they went ahead and decided to close Hammersmith anyway. And it doesn't stop there, because another thing they've sneaked out is the fact that they voluntarily giving away about £8.5 million of community care money from Hammersmith to other parts of London. They've decided to do that, not because they were told to, because they chose to do that. And the latest news is that one of the GP practices in White City, we've heard about GP closures in the East End, three GP practices are closing in Westminster, and we now may be faced with one closing in White City as well. That's GP care, community care, acute care, none of them being increased, as we were promised there would be if there were A&E closures, all of them being cut back. That's where we are today. That is the face of Cameron and Hunt's NHS. This is the issue for the next general election. This is the issue for the next year, because despite all the gains and advances we've made, because of those cuts, and because these people are still intent on closing A&Es and hospitals in West London, we have to keep fighting until we stop them. I'm delighted to see Ruth Cadbury here. She's the Labour PPC for Brentford and Isleworth. And I also bring, she couldn't be here today, but I'm seeing her tomorrow, Rupert Huck, the Labour PPC for Ealing Central and Acton. I say that not because we are a Labour Party organisation, this is a broad church that we've heard from four or five different political parties. But where there is somebody, be it the Labour Party or any other party, who will stand up with a chance of winning and will defeat the Tories and others who will destroy our NHS, we have to ensure that we take power and we have to tell them the truth. Unlike what the Tories were telling them for the last year, they will respond. They will go out and vote. They will go out and campaign because they care. They care about their family's health, their health, and they care about the institution of the NHS. And that is the message we will continue to get across for the next year. So thank you for your support so far. Well done to Save Our Hospitals. Let's go on and keep fighting. Thank you.
Thanks, Andy. I don't want to finish by thanking everybody, because I'll inevitably leave people out. And anyway, everybody